You're good.
All right. So, for those of you who didn't know me, my name is Nick Powell. My senior project was a community involvement project. So basically what I did was I volunteered at the Little Lavender Farm. This was something that I'd always loved. I always loved doing farm work. It was always something that interested me. And I just never realized how big of an impact it would have on me. Because even from the start, I found that everything about it, from just eating, doing the hay, and just communicating with others, was something that I loved. And something that would eventually lead me to find out that was what I wanted to do for my senior project. It was funny because I've actually been volunteering there for about a year before I started my senior project on this. So I already had a bit of insight, and I was already, you know, well into volunteering, and I knew what I had to do. So it was just a matter of kind of applying my senior project to that. So this is kind of an aerial view of the farm. It's a 72-acre farm with roughly 60 or so horses on it right now. On the top left, you see that big white building. It's a quarantine building. So when they get new horses in, whether they were just dropped off by their owner or they were taken from a bad situation, they go there before they're kind of introduced into the bigger population. In kind of the center of the screen, you can see all the different paddocks. This farm has kind of a different philosophy than most others. They want to have horses live as naturally as possible, so you never see like a big barn. They have their own paddocks, and that's where they live. Basically, the goal of the farm is to provide a permanent and safe place in which the horses can live, and it's just a big animal sanctuary. The majority of the animals at the farm have been physically abused, but like I said earlier, some of them have just been dropped off because they're only equipped with a vehicle. Right to the right of that big white building is basically the Britain building. It was basically basically dedicated to one of the girls, Brittany, who had volunteered at the farm, and she passed away a few years ago in an incident. But so that's where all the dogs are kept, and it's just kind of like a little memento to her. And basically in the center, where all the big grouping buildings are, is the place where all the, it's like the main buildings where all the volunteers go. So this is Teresa. She's the founder of the Little Lavender Farm. She started it in 1996, and basically it was her lifelong goal to establish an equine sanctuary in which people could just interact safely with horses. Basically, so she started it in 1996. In 2002, it was noticed for being a non-profit foundation, and basically this farm is run totally by donations, so it's a very important thing for them to get donations, whether it be through charities or them having their own set of fundraisers. So the Little Lavender Farm is mainly an equine rehabilitation and rescue center. It also provides sanctuary for a variety of different animals. Like I said, animals come to the farm either through, you know, processes like just getting the animal from a bad place or from owners that can't take care of them. And a lot of times they actually have to file for ownership of those animals because they were at a bad property, so the people that have the horses still want to keep them. The farm ranges has a ton of animals. They have animals from, as you can see in this on the left, they have a big bull and a blue bull, and to smaller animals like the two bunnies. Like I said, there are many different animals. They have their own separate programs for, like, on the left you see the Pyrenees puppies, and in the center there's Patton and Neptune, which are two of the newer horses they came in last year. And they also get birds in, like, bird and parade. One of the funny things about this is, well, about this farm is they have so many different animals, and often the animals kind of get along in different ways. Like, on the left you'll see there's a big turkey with goats and chickens, and on the right there's Winnie and Sassy, which are two small little horses, and they're with Crooked Bill. The reason why Bill is at the farm is kind of a funny story, but a different story is he was found in some way DCR'd, and his beak got messed up, so he was unable to live in a while, and it was just something that really altered him. So she ended up bringing him to the farm, and coincidentally, was actually just standing around one day, and this little rabbit ended up coming towards her. And the video showed them just playing together, and it's just a really funny little interaction that you never really thought would have happened otherwise. It's, you know, it's not normal for a horse to be playing with a small one. So.
Alright.
So. On the farm, basically everything is done by the volunteers. There's no one that's there that's paid to do the work that's needed, whether it be feeding or, you know, mucking stones. It's all done by the volunteers. There's a volunteer base of roughly 200 people right now that just come in on their own free time and just do work there and help out. There's also been different programs like AmeriCorps, Kids Care, and United Way that have brought in their own people, and they kind of helped out around the farm, whether it be, like I said, from mucking salt, cleaning, defeating, and also they've done a lot of the repairs on the buildings. So this past year, the farm was recognized, and I thought this was really cool. It was the 2015 New Hampshire Spirit of Award, Spirit of New Hampshire Award. It's basically given when they see a program that brings volunteers and they see how big of an impact those volunteers can have, not only on the community, but on bettering the whole state of New Hampshire. So I thought that was really cool that they finally got recognized for having such a good impact. Alright, so working on the farm. I kind of delved into what I did personally here. Like I said earlier, I'm usually there on Sundays, you know, or other times during the week, but I roughly work 5 to 7 hours each time. And one of the big things that I do there is feeding the animals. And basically, so what I do is I end up, as you can see in the picture, getting the grain buckets ready. They have a feed chart that lists everything that you have to know and all the foods and different like vitamins that you have to add into them. So that's something that for 60 horses can take me roughly 2 hours to do alone. And that's without doing the hay, which is another hour, and then feeding out, which can take another 2 to 3. So all in all, just the feeding process can take roughly 5 hours, which is kind of crazy, but that's what you have to do. It's like it says on the PowerPoint, the animals are fed 2 times a day, 7 days a week, and 365 days a year. Whether the weather's bad or it's good, the volunteers still have to do it. It's a job that, you know, the animals are relying on you, so if you don't do it, it's not going to get done. And it's just, that's just a big commitment, you know. Alright, so kind of the big picture of what I wanted to do for my project was it all revolved around equine therapy. So right here I have one of the, one of the programs, Heather's Healing Humans with the Rescued Animals. What that revolved around was taking veterans that suffered from PTSD and other things, but mainly PTSD, and they'd bring them in, kind of introduce them to the program. They have a couple day program that would actually introduce them to a horse. They'd work one-on-one throughout that weekend with that horse, and it would just kind of help them to cope, and it would help build skills that they need to kind of reintegrate themselves into civilian life. It would also help build confidence, and it would just do a number on them. It was a really good thing. Some of it I got to witness personally. One of the funny stories was I actually met one of the veterans later on who had participated in this program, and I didn't know it at first, but one of the horses, Teddy, he'd actually been working with, so I got to introduce him back to Teddy, and it's just amazing to see. Like, most people would never realize the bond between a person and a horse, but it's actually a lot stronger than you think, because the horse, you could see, his eyes lit up right when he saw him, and he recognized him right away. So this program, like I said, basically helps them to cope with PTSD. And one of the big things is it kind of helps them to lower their guard and release some of the stress. Because often people with PTSD are hypervigilant, which means that they're always on guard. And when you're always on guard, you have a high level of stress. Right. So the benefits from equine therapy. So equine therapy, like I said, is an amazing thing. It can help build confidence and work ethic. You build confidence through just basically the bond through that with that animal. Like I said, that bond is something that takes a long time to have with a horse. A horse it's an animal that isn't trusting right away. They're a prey animal, so they're always on the lookout. And you have to kind of let the horse know your intentions, and your intentions are good. So that bond takes your work ethic. Your work ethic comes from working with that horse, and it's, like I said, that bond's something that takes a long time, so you're going to have to be consistent with working with them. And, yeah. So your assertiveness, that kind of comes into play when you're working with a horse. You have to let them know what your intentions truly are. You have to go about it in a good way, though, because, like I said, they're a herd animal and a prey animal, so they're always on guard. Responsibility. That's basically just caring for the horse and being good. A horse is a lot of work, whether it's grooming or feeding. You always have to keep up on it, and it's a big chore to do. One of the big things is decrease stress with my therapy. Like I highlighted in the Heather's Healing Humans with rescued animals, it's a big stress reliever, and it does that basically by just helping the person to realize that everything's not bad and that they can have a bond with an animal that will just help them in general. And not only does it help the animal, it also helps the person. So it's kind of a two-way street there. The person really experiences joy when that bond's formed with the animal. It's kind of an amazing thing, because typically when you meet a horse, he's on her own. Once you build that bond, he's going to kind of come over to you, and it's basically just like having a really good friend. And it's just a great thing. The social benefits. The cool thing about horses is they mirror your reactions. A horse isn't an animal that's going to judge you on how you look, you know, your appearance. It's going to judge you on how you act towards them. So if you're nice to a horse, it's going to be nice back. And if, you know, you're like anxious and acting kind of weird, then it'll be like the old stuff back. So yeah. The personal impact. Personally with me, like today, just getting up on stage here is a big struggle for me. I'm not one that's very open. I'm typically more shy. Throughout working at the farm, the biggest impact for myself has been it's improved my social skills. When I first started going to the farm, one of the things that I do is I kind of tag along on the tours and I help people. And basically what I'd be helping them with is telling them about the animals and just giving them the information that they wanted to know about the animals, whether it be the adoption process or just the personal facts about it. So that's really helped me. Leadership, the biggest part of that was really when I got to kind of train some of the people that wanted to do the same kind of job that I was doing, which was basically just the feeding and just helping out in general. So that was a good thing. Organization, that was huge. I'm kind of a messy person. If you look at my backpack, you won't be able to find a single thing. But it's kind of helped me to realize that if you're not organized, you can't get things done. So that's kind of helped me overall with just school in general too, just being more organized. Time management, that's been huge. That's so big because you have to kind of balance your home life and school, and then on top of that, volunteering. I was volunteering on Sundays, which is a big thing. And then responsibility, it's, just this whole thing is a huge responsibility because, like I said, with all the feeding and stuff, if you don't get the stuff right, that can be bad because a lot of the horses have, different, not really disabilities, but different quirks about them. So they need, different supplements and different things in the feed. So you have to be really vigilant. Stress reducer. With school in general, I'm not one who really likes school at all. But this is kind of one of those happy medium things that helps me to just have fun, and it's a great stress reducer on the weekend. Because I do plan on continuing this every weekend. Friendships, I've learned, I've gotten to notice a lot of good people at the farm, and I've developed a lot of friendships with the different people there. So that's been great. And then also farming skills at the bottom. This kind of ties into just